Deborah, call me. I'ma come clean, I got deep. Paranoia got me rolling in my sleeves, okay. Dating cause I'm up and up the fees. Whole team got these on their keys all day. I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day.
From the banks of the Ohio River, there's a look at Paul Brown Stadium here in Cincinnati, Ohio. This crowd loves their orange and black. The scene just a short time ago, they were in full roar as their guys burst out of the locker room. We're ready for football as the Bengals get set to do battle with the Pittsburgh Steelers. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. First carry for the second-year man, Joe Mixon. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31. This running game so important for them, and they know that. It helped lead them to a victory last week when he was over 100 yards.
Let's face it, it's their identity, and that's what they want to play to. They want to be that team that runs the ball really well each and every week, and right now we're seeing a pretty good pattern of that happening.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker, and what that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Is going to be incomplete.
Certainly looked like they were getting ready to convert there on third down, but what an effort to get his hand on that one, knock it away, and brings up a fourth down decision.
He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. This is taken at the 23. It'll be a 10-yard return following a punt of 45. And the Steelers will go on offense here, first and 10. Rudolph going to lead the Steelers up now, first and 10 at the 33-yard line. First carry for James Conner. Found a little room there as he's up to about the 37. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Rudolph. And with a flag down, he goes down. So they're able to sack him. Now the penalty looks like it could be holding. Let's find out. And this third down looking very tough after the holding penalty. Third and long.
Detroit! 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 All right, now, Lucky 56. Lucky 56. Hot!
From the gun, here's Rudolph. Going top shelf for Smith-Schuster. Oh, he almost picked it. Nearly a turnover there on their opening drive. That's a throw he'd like to have back. Now fourth down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Give them 11 yards that time on the return. And the Bengals will take over here, first and 10. The Bengals getting set to go. And our game's hit a little bit of a lull here, a little bit of a snag. Punts on back-to-back drives.
And old-school coaches don't necessarily mind that. Didn't turn it over, right? Didn't create a big play for the other team. Right now, what you're looking for is can you get...
And now a fumble. The ball's out. But I think a Bengal player was able to get in there. He was. And they'll keep possession of the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back. Because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
And his throw is going to be incomplete. He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. And it's third down. Well, too much oomph, too much mustard there on that pass.
Yeah, really turned it loose, didn't they? Really cut loose with that one. Sharp, strong. Didn't lead to a completion, though. Made it very difficult.
Third down, Brissett. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
I think the punter might start to get into a pretty good rhythm here if he keeps getting opportunities. But that's the last thing his team wants to have happen, right? The last thing you want to see is your punter feeling pretty good because he's out there all the time.
Yeah, first quarter only, but they're 0 for 2 on third down conversions to start this thing. A good return there. Call it 13 yards. And out will come the offense as they take over. And the Steelers set to take the field. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Detroit!
On second down, here's Rudolph. He'll get this one to Switzer. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 8 yards on the completion, but now they face third down. Rudolph on third down. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. Exactly right. A lost opportunity.
21 yards. Well done on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. They've had it twice. They punted twice. Not the start they were hoping for.
Not at all. And let's face it, every facility we visit, everyone talks about converting on third down, how big that is. In this situation, they've had to punt it away twice. So they're furiously going over things on the sidelines. What do we need to do to pick up a first down and change our momentum?
Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Second down throw for Brissett. Buying time to his left. And that's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. Steps away to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep back over the middle. So they took a shot there on third down, couldn't get it. Now it's four.
And what did we talk with them about prior to the game? Their ability to move the chains, pick up first downs. So far, 0 for 3 on third down. If that continues, they'll have little chance of winning this one.
And he's getting a workout here in this first quarter as he gets it away. And this one will wind up being down just outside of that 20-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field.
And this is their third drive right now, maybe not about points, just about getting something. They haven't gotten a first down yet in this game.
It's a mental barrier you don't think about until you go a couple of drives without getting a first down. Then all of a sudden it looms big. It gets harder and harder to actually attain that first down.
Give him 9 on the carry that time, and they're set up with a 2nd and 1. And they give this time to the tailback. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a 3rd and 2. Yards.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flipped field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's 1st and 10, just outside the 30.
Hey, hey, watching that, Marty, Marty.
Connor. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half.
Detroit!
Maybe
Detroit!
Not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains
gone,
turn
gone,
into bigger runs
gone,
later.
Gone. All right, now, lucky 56, lucky 56.
Here's Rudolph now on 2nd down. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down. Couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
A lot of contact there, but there was no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
Right,
they head
six,
to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down.
Go!
Out of the gun, Rudolph. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Vance McDonald, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. Extra point put through by Boswell. And that makes the score 7-0. Boswell on now to kick this one away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Now the Cincinnati offense ready to see what they can do here.
The results for them so far, not that great. Well, not good at all. 3 drives, 3 punts.
Yeah, and now what you're doing is you're looking at your play sheet. You're trying to figure out what you're going against defensively. I wonder, are they showing them something they haven't seen or anticipated in practice, and maybe that's throwing them off?
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, 2nd and 10. On 2nd down, here's Mixon. And not a whole lot doing there, so he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Bud Dupree, a former first-round pick, in on the stop.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative, but you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. But I would like to see them open things up, because otherwise this defense is going to gang up on the run and set them down.
Now a shot taken on 3rd down, but it's going to wind up incomplete. Here's Shane Leckler now, as he'll punt it away for the 4th time today. The But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it. He loses it. Somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. It's Connor as they stay on the ground. And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. Right off the bat, it's a first down to start the drive, 12 yards.
Well, as we've learned over the years, just because a guy plays left tackle doesn't mean he doesn't have run-blocking abilities. And we just saw it there. Controlled the line of scrimmage, created a big game.
That's kind of a bonus. He's there to protect that high value that you have back under center, but he creates space in the run game.
Yeah, not only can he dance, he can mash, too.
Geno Atkins, the Pro Bowler, in there on the stop.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Rudolph throwing on second down. Flushed out right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. Vance McDonald, the tight end, was the target. And that'll make it third down.
But he kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
Throwing on third down, here's Rudolph. On the left side, it's McDonald. The Steelers picking up 15 yards there and a first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
And he'll fight his way forward to about the 48-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Green 39. Gone, 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 gone. Hot, hot.
They'll fake it. Now Rudolph. He'll wind up with positive yardage. It's a gain of 3, but now it's third down. And the Steelers on third down. They've been good, 3 for 4 thus far. This will be third and 5. Shotgun snap for Rudolph. Looking for Moncrief, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 46. Past the 20. And he will bring it back. It's a pick 6 for Bengals TD. Short throw pick 6 right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six. We'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, let's just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
They told us. They've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
And throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
Well, I guess that answers the question whether or not they want him throwing it again right away after throwing the pick 6 on the previous drive.
Yeah, not something conservative or underneath. Pretty big shot right there.
Got him right back in the saddle and said, go ahead and sling it, big guy.
Here's Rudolph. And a hit jarred it loose.
It's incomplete. And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. The Steelers on third down. They've converted three out of five thus far. This is third and 10.
Gone, 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 gone.
Here's Rudolph. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Geno Atkins in there to drop him for a loss of 10. And it'll be fourth and long. Here's Jordan Berry now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. Ross on the return. So possession goes over here on the punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. The Bengals offense now, they head back onto the field. And right now these guys, they're shuffling a little bit, maybe doubting, because three straight drives have ended with them punting the football away.
Yeah, so you start pointing fingers at each other a little bit, asking a lot of questions. What are you seeing? What are you getting? Maybe trying to narrow down your playbook a little bit and maybe get simpler rather than more complex in order to try and fashion together a drive.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
That's a lot of beef thundering downfield off of the toss play, and it takes me back to when I was a kid and watching USC play. Remember the old toss that they ran? They used to call student body right or student body left because everyone was out in front of the ball carrier. In fact, one of their favorite plays, it was called roast stem right or roast stem left, depending on the form.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 38, and the possession is theirs at their own 43-yard line.
When
I saw the pressure coming at him, that just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy, and can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We'll come back to Cincinnati after this.
Detroit! Detroit!
From the 50, it's Rudolph. This one complete, right side to McDonald. And he's going to take it in for a Steeler touchdown. Vance McDonald with his second TD of the game, his sixth on the year. And the Steelers get the quick strike touchdown. Extra point now by Boswell. Boswell good with the extra point, and that makes the score 14-7. Boswell on now to kick this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Spins past it. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And out now, here come the Bengals. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. Forced out to his left. Throw left side complete to Ross. And they'll get him down here at the 23. That throw good for 4. It's second down.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Now a deep ball there on second down, but it'll wind up incomplete. So the long attempt falls innocently to the ground and it brings up third. These guys have punted 4 times already and they're staring at a 5th, barring a conversion here on third down. Set from the gun on third.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked up by the rookie Terrell Edmonds. And he'll get this back to the 32-yard line.
So that's back-to-back drives where they've thrown an interception. Ordinarily, we look at the offense and say, what's going on with your scheme? Maybe we should look at the defense and just give them a whole lot of credit. They've got them frustrated right now.
They run with Connor. And now running right through it. And he'll be brought down. Oh, that's a face mask. Certainly looked like it. Indeed, here come the flags. Well, we looked at each other right away. We knew that flag was coming out.
And I always enjoy the conversation post, because officials always tell you, I don't want to throw the flag, but you caused the play. You did it. I had to.
Got his man. It's caught for a Steelers touchdown. Make that now three touchdown passes for the rookie Mason Rudolph. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead.
And remember, partner, that's a rookie quarterback back there. Apparently, he's getting the hang of this NFL thing pretty quickly.
Yeah, three touchdown passes. You're right. He looks comfortable. What are they doing? Anything in particular?
Well, they keep talking about making sure they're giving him plays that fit his talents and also maybe shrinking the playbook a little bit. They did tell us that. Bottom line, he's really good.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator? Sometimes they just make a joke. All right, guys, you had your fun?
On, all right, throw go. It out the window.
Yeah, let's get back on track here. And sometimes that'll work just fine.
I guess it's time now to lean on that leadership.
And the Steeler pressure too much here. He's going down. T.J. Watt in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year.
Now they're in some hot water now. After that sack, it's second and 21.
Ohio! Ohio! Flex round! Flex round!
Play action now. Brissett on the move to his left. Pressure gets to him and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line.
So, Brandon, we sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
After the sack, they'll come up now third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to let this one go deep. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect. So we've reached halftime here with the visiting Steelers out in front. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. That'll be taken in the end zone. And with a marker down, he's up just past the 25-yard line, but I think they're going to be going backwards. Let's check the call. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. Here comes a first down throw for Rudolph. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long.
Detroit! Detroit! All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Watch it now, Barney!
Rudolph now to throw. And McDonald here over the middle. And he'll get it up here this time to the 21. That one good for 17 as they're set up better now for third down.
I don't know whether I want to be a fly on the wall or not when they hear the explanation of how he, one of the bigger targets on the field, the tight end could be that wide open and uncovered downfield. Who blew that assignment?
Somebody did.
No doubt about it. There's no way you're not going to account for him.
Completes it to Moncrief, left side. And all the way down to the 24-yard line. A big play on third there for the Steelers. 55 yards. So barely time to catch our breath. Here's first and 10 just outside the red zone. On first down, Rudolph. And that is incomplete.
I remember a coach telling me a long time ago the difference between playing corner and safety in the NFL. Corner is like the Autobahn. Everybody just flying by, and these corners have been really busy in this game, although they got it done on the last play.
On the last play, yes, but there have been some good numbers put up against them offensively. Here's Connor. And he'll keep it moving down to the 15-yard line. 9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with third and one.
Despite the blitz, they're still able to pick up a nice solid game. The disadvantage of blitzing often alters the normal spacing and run fits and leaves creases like they were able to exploit right there.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender was making sure his guy couldn't hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. And Boswell's kick is good. And that'll push the lead up to 17. So unable to convert for the touchdown inside the red zone, but they do come away with three.
Yeah, it's a 32-yarder. That's essentially an extra point nowadays, right? Because it's 33 as a general rule for these guys. So it should be a simple kick. But you know what's really strange nowadays? When they miss an extra point, I think they carry that with them longer than missing a field goal because an extra point's supposed to be automatic.
Absolutely, and I would think even field goals inside of 30 yards, even though they're substantially shorter than a PAT, it just has a different feel, doesn't it?
A different feel, a different vibe. That's what I get from all the kickers I talk to. They always say, if I miss an extra point, that's the one that bothers me more.
And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line.
Tough first half for him, unable to put up the numbers he's used to producing. But with a guy like him, you and I both know it just takes a couple of explosive touches for him to make an impact on this game and on the stat sheet as well.
They'll break the huddle, come up on second and 8 at the 27-yard line. Brissett now on second down. Green with a catch left side. The reception good for 7. It's third down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tough for guys trying to get to the football.
And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line.
I think it's pretty evident. We can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. Here's Shane Leckler now as he's on for the fifth time here today. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Out comes the Steeler offense now, ready to see what they can do here. This is sort of what you would call a put-away drive, isn't it? I mean, they score here, especially a touchdown. It's almost out of reach.
It certainly feels that way, and I think that they're going to call their plays accordingly because what you really want to do, even though you know the scoreboard is still up there and the game's going to go on.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. And into the end zone. Touchdown. The rookie Mason Rudolph with 4 touchdown passes now in the ball game, and the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. Boswell for the extra point. Extra point put through by Boswell, and the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Boswell on now to kick this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The Bengal offense now gets set to head back out onto the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
But you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline and puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
A really good pickup of 28 yards. Operating out of Steeler territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Throwing, Brissett, flush to his right, and he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. John Ross, the one he was looking for, and now it's second down.
This defense is continuing to contest every deep ball that is thrown downfield, and look, it comes man on man, and you've got to trust yourself and go up at that moment of truth and make a play on the football.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10.
Here we go. One, nine.
To throw is Brissett. Escaping the pressure right. And his throw here is incomplete. Tyler Boyd, the former Pitt Panther, was the target. And that takes us from second to third down.
Well, they're slinging it. And then there's one you got to put a timer on, huh? I mean, that one came in hot.
That came in hot, but overthrown, out of his reach and incomplete. So now third and 10, a big play to start the drive, but nothing since. Here's Brissett. He's going to air it out deep for Green. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a fourth down. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary, they really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense. Great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. And especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to them.
Fourth down, Brissett. Eluding the pressure right. Now he's going to throw deep right side. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete. Marvin Lewis tries for it, but comes up empty. And this defense will take over right near midfield at the 49-yard line. Rudolph going to lead the Steelers up now, first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 49. On first and 10, Rudolph. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10.
Gone, gone, gone. Detroit, Detroit.
Back to throw, Rudolph. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Preston Brown, the linebacker. And he's just across midfield and down at the... yard line. And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. Going deep downfield for Ross. That's going to be caught by Ross for a Bengal touchdown.
play there. His second touchdown on the season. And thanks to the interception, the Bengals offense cashes in with six. The offense going to stay on the field as they will line up and go for two. From the gun, Jones flushed out right, looking middle, and it's incomplete. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite, but in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed near the goal line on a two-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And Charles, you'd have to think this is where you want to start taking some time off the clock.
Oh, definitely, because you got the lead, right? You take a good look up there and you say, okay, what do we need to do here? Well, you're not in full out protect mode. You want to make sure you run it, throw it safe, take some time off, and eat it up.
Rudolph going to lead the Steelers up now, first and 10 at their own 22. They start with a give to Connor, and he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. Carlos Dunlap, the defensive end, the one to bring him down.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
Here's Rudolph now on second down. He's going to fire one deep over the... And got his man complete. And all the way down to the 26. A big play that time for Pittsburgh. 47 yards.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there, for a big gainer. That's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. But if you hit enough crossers and underneath routes and curls, start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a changeup in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the changeup, and on that play, it worked for big yardage.
17 more yards on that one as they keep the drive rolling. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit them, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Rudolph. And caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. In for the score. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead.
Brandon, remind me again, this is a rookie quarterback we're seeing?
A rookie indeed.
I mean, because my eyes are telling me something I'm having trouble believing. Five touchdown passes. He's thrown five in this game. Are you kidding me?
This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. So now the Bengal offensive unit back out onto the field. They have been struggling. I would imagine at halftime they went through some possible changes. Well, those changes aren't working, so now where do you go?
I think that now it's much more in their head. And what I mean by that is just what you said. You've gone over the changes. I bet they were pretty clinical at the half, not too emotional. They might need to go to the emotional side because you've got to find something, some spark somewhere. And so far, just being calm hasn't exactly worked.
They need any spark at this point.
Line of scrimmage, again the 25, second and 10. Jones now, throwing again on second and 10. Looking sideline, incomplete. He was looking for John Ross that time. And it's third down.
I know our vantage point might be a little bit better way up here, but that looked like an ill-advised throw to me. I didn't see anything open, and this play just didn't look right from the beginning.
It did not. I thought he might get outside and just chuck it away. Dangerous pass, incomplete. These guys have punted four times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down.
Here's Jones on third down, being chased out left. Going deep downfield for Ross. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down, so hang on. A big call coming on third down.
So the field flips here as they'll go to work at the 20 now on first and 10. They go play action here on first down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line hasn't done a great job of protecting him in this game, and there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside, probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Got to keep his composure. Can't let the defense know that they're getting to him.
Hey, guys. Hey, come on, let's go! Grand 38!
Jones, going to throw again. To the left side here for Eifert. And he's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. And they'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective game nonetheless.
And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. Now Jones, trying to set up the screen, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 12. He's at the 50. 30. 20. 10. 5. And he's in for 6 and a Steeler touchdown. Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick 6 makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6, and now the kick is away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And the decision to come out is going to cost him 5 as he's taken down right at the 20. Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And last time, decent field position through the pick 6. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
Meanwhile, they take a shot to start the drive, but this is going to wind up incomplete. They'll try again from the 20 on 2nd and 10.
Hey, four down.
Now Jones, off the play fake. He's going to air it out deep for Green. And they went for a big play through the air on 2nd down, couldn't connect. Now it's 3rd.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball. And they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, 4th quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like
Ohio,
that downfield.
Four down.
Off play action. Jones. Pressure comes and the Steelers take him down.
I think normally we would talk.
So I count sitting numbers in the hood, do what I say, do tip. Break bread, a fake, dead, a bit, to hate that. 50 million, you die, to make that. Middle, you vote for Trump, see me outside, well, you know what's up. I ain't hearing no peace talk, ain't funny, no hee haw. Like a Black Panther, weak to the teeth, try to weep. Swear to God, I could have been Freddie Gray. A Mike Brown, get down with a homie and a half a.
blame it by Sandra Bland. Listen, boy, you're challenging with the running man. I was challenging with a hand. What you see before you, what they ain't told you from nothing, man. Gray and hustle over everything. And hit the king like an 18-wheeler in and out of air lane. Never been a part of they in crowd. Got a problem with me, I said, yeah, I got the same friend that I came in with, ducking all that lane. Hey.
Everyone that knows on go. I rolled in a 4x4. Believe if I kept gon' go see me with, ain't gon' see them no more. They love when I talk, they rolled by the car, lie, went and bought it. Caught case, took the case and a phone. They will watch you give a dip. I live that they rapping back, counting them back with they capping back. Bang roll mama, we know it did. We cashing out, we bagging that. Stacking up, they're zero. Certified neighborhood hero. You can try one of them. Better not try with me though. Hey.
Bring it in, bring it in. Roll it down by two. We're gonna go out here, run this play for the win. Let's go get it. I formation, 28 sweeps, blue 14. Watch left.
We to the mat, Atlanta hat, cop to the left, turn to the back. Try to see we weren't having that. Sit with your head, drop it. I with Alabama at. That would get for trying to battle rap. Hit, be winning, no drive, but we running. Walk up to you while you showing the stunt, till you up that jury and money. Playing game, thinking show no funny, till my young win for me. Yeah. For the love of the bankroll, keep it bent to you. Don't nobody care about it, don't nobody wanna hear about it. You got problem, huh? Well, it's the same thing for everybody. I ain't gon' lie. I promise that a day go by. I ain't on the grind if I ain't on fire. If it one thing I won't get, it can't go by. Tryna put seat wheels on a Range Rover. I ain't finna play no game, that what you know, so if you think at the top, tell I move over. Modern day Tupac in a new hover. Know them, now come with us and down. We dodge it, steady deck and clown. We chasing meals so we can butt that down. Top, but we run the town. But with millions in with no cap and gown. We're all in what happened now. Metal throne, concrete crown. Call that line, you getting beat. Real white veteran. What academy? They remember me when they sick and needed their medicine. Better watch your partner, you from Ryan Hill. Thinking sweet, you got the wrong idea. Get left out there, tell them so what. I kept trap music, all black. Still, I'm that stupid. Still down to do it if you ask stupid. Get locked up and get back to it, yeah. Trap music, all black. Get locked up and get back to it, yeah.
Ay, ay, I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no, I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros, ain't no, but don't push me, fingers itching on that, plotting on my come up, gotta watch they at my nose, long nights I, just to hit the studio, now I'm eating steak and shrimp, I ain't eating sloppy joe, looking to the mirror, flexing now and in his glow, bust off like a, welcome to the rodeo, shorty wanna me, cousin, wearing gold, I came up and made it happen, now it's, by the stove, big inside this case is one. Do me dirty, I'ma find you, lay out on the flow. 19 with a I got rich by myself. Rather do this alone, I wasn't asking for no help. They keep asking how I'm winning with the card that I was dealt. Boy, I work hard for the seat and I ain't buckling my belt. Call my brother on the phone, he said, broski, you a star. I said, brother, hold it down, so we'll all be living large. And it's crazy how last year was out my garage. Now I'm in a good position for this life, can't sabotage. I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no, I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no, but don't push me, fingers itching on that, plotting on my come up, gotta watch they at my nose. Long nights I, just to hit the studio. Now I'm eating steak and shrimp, I ain't eating sloppy joe. Looking to the mirror, flexing now it in his glow. Bust off like a, welcome to the rodeo. I got tattoos on my face, I use that as motivation. I can never get a job, so for my dream I'm dedicated. For a second lost myself, I was too busy getting busy. Now they see me out in public and be knowing what my name is. All these rappers want the clout and the life of being famous. I just wanna be stable, tell my family we made it. I was coming from my spot, a young had to be patient. Now I'm running up, these bands can hit the island for vacation. I've been know my haters, you could say I'm constipated. 5 racks on his fit, just a stunt while I'm in Vegas. For my body, shout out to my Caleb Young. Got the cake up, now he's on the data. I ain't folding under pressure, I ain't switching for no, I ain't talking to no cop and I ain't telling on my bros. Ain't no, but don't push me, fingers itching on that, plotting on my come up, gotta watch they at my nose. Long nights I, just to hit the studio. Now I'm eating steak and shrimp, I ain't eating sloppy joe. Looking to the mirror, flexing now and in his glow. Bust off like a, welcome to the rodeo.
town like I'm Jordan. Need to go get your walk on my way, I'ma score it. Lamborghini, I don't want no Porsche. I'ma fire, don't touch me, I'm torching. Had a fist on my teeth, I went Porsche. Put the town on my back, I'm a horseman. One more year, I'ma make it a fortress. They load me in the bay like he 40. I be sitting inside of the Moreland.